might be wondering, what is it that this man's doing in front of me now? I've got a fishing rod. We've got some charity workers here. We're trying to catch people. We're all trying to catch fish today. And if you think about it, everyone going around, you're all fish, aren't you, really? We're all trying to get something from you, if you like. But I'm going to tell you today something we'd like to give you for free if I don't fall off this box. Now, I wonder if you think like this a bit. Do you think that there's things in your life that are trying to tempt you? Do you think there's always things that are dangling in front of you? Things you know you shouldn't do, things that you know are bad, but they're a bit interesting. Do you know what I'm talking about? Like, if you get, well, this man knows, you know what I mean? A lot of people, they might do things they shouldn't. Maybe there's a lot of people that they like to drink. Maybe there's a lot of people and they like to do drugs. Maybe there's a lot of people and they do things outside of marriage they shouldn't. And all of these things, it's a bit like we've got a bar of chocolate in front of us every single day, isn't it? It's like that, and it's almost like it's saying, go on, just take it. Does anybody, look, this is really nice chocolate. If anyone takes this bar of chocolate, it's yours. Do you want it? It's your, if anyone wants it, then please take it from that. Anyone want, very welcome. I can see people are interested. Just take it from me. Now, I don't know if the people going by, there's someone I believe in, I believe exists. And I wonder if you believe he exists as well. There's a man, he begins with D. The devil. Have you heard of the devil before? Do you think he exists? You see, the devil said the greatest trick he could ever play is to make people think he didn't exist. And all day long, the devil, Satan, he's trying to entice us. He's trying to draw us in. I'll tell you why. Satan is trapped in a place called hell. And he wants every single one of you to be in that place called hell. So he'll say, come on, get blind drunk. Hey, have you heard of Logan Paul? Who's heard of that guy, Logan Paul, that's been on the news? Yeah. Have you heard of him? Yeah. What did he get in trouble for? Yeah, he put a bad video on YouTube. Can I just say something about Logan Paul? That's what the world's doing. We've got to a point where we're laughing at serious things like suicide. And Logan Paul thought it was a great idea. Let's film a suicide and then everyone will laugh at it. And we've got all these people thinking, yeah, let's laugh at suicide. And that's what the devil wants. He wants us to laugh at suicide. When someone gets absolutely blind drunk, have you seen it? And they're on the floor and they're knocked out. What do? We laugh at them, but there's nothing funny about that. When a man commits, you know, adultery and cheats on his husband and wife, we put that as entertainment. And the devil is trying to spin these lies to us. Do you know the biggest lie the devil tells you? There's no God. Do you know what some people believe? Now, this is madness. Now, are you ready for this? Some people actually believe that the whole universe came from nothing. They believe there's no God that made the universe. Now, if I put a painting in front of you and said that painting came from nothing, you look at me and you say, what a weird man, what a strange man. And yet, our world spins all of this rubbish and believes it. But I'll tell you, you can be rescued from all these lies through Jesus Christ. What do you think of the man Jesus Christ? The Savior who hung on a cross. You know this? Do you know they spat on him? You know they beat him? You know they put a crown of thorns on his head and they nailed him to a cross? Not because Jesus had done anything wrong, because you and I have done bad things. So, do you see this fist here, right? What do you reckon? I know I'm looking. Do you think this fist has ever hit anyone before? What do you reckon? What do you think? Do you think it's hit anyone before? Maybe. It has. I mean, I said this in Wigan once and a man said, no, you look too soft to hit anyone. But I've hit people. Do you think these eyes have ever looked at things they shouldn't have? They have. They definitely have. But then ask me this, am I going to heaven? I am. Do you know why? Not because I've done anything wrong. I'm a bad person. Because Jesus died on a cross, taking the punishment for my sin. And the good news is this. Today, you can be forgiven too. There's only two types of people that get to heaven. Perfect people and forgiven people. So let me ask you this. Are you perfect? You're perfect. No. But you can all be forgiven. We stick around for one final challenge. Give me 10 more seconds. 10 more seconds of your time, okay? You ready for it, okay? What would you think of me now if I said to you, Harry Potter's a terrible book? What would you think of me? Okay, what would you think of me if I said, Harry Potter's a terrible book, but I've never read it before? What would you think of me then? Say, really? read it first and then make a judgment. Don't say the Bible's a load of rubbish without reading it first. And I'm going to give you a portion of the Bible for free. If anyone wants to take it, read it, think it through. Jesus died on a cross and he rose there for people. Thank you. Anyone else wants one? They're absolutely free.
He
I'd
wants
love
one
to
as
give
well.
You. I saw you before. I saw
one
name up. Jude, is it?
Has, you know?
I could hear you on the train.
I could not.
Yeah, I could hear
was
you.
Was that you?
Anyone else wants another one?
Yeah, I would have one, brother.
You want one? Yeah, would anyone else like? We've got a book here. Those who say I don't believe, if anyone wants it, it's worth some money in a shop, you can take it. If there's any atheists going by, if there's anyone who doesn't believe in God, read this book. Because it's true, you know, you can't knock things and say there's no God. How do you not know that God isn't on Pluto or he isn't on another planet? You've never been in every single place. How do you know there's no God? So may God bless you. Have a think about these things and thank you for stopping.
Yes, shalom alaikum.